Hello guys, it's Michael Mechanical here. Today I'm just making a bit of an update because tomorrow would have been another update and it's likely that the car might have come home and might have been done here, like finish it off here and get it running here. But there's a possibility that's not going to be the case this time around just because I essentially got a call today, so my extra plan is fulfilled in one way, not the other, so it's not going to be me bringing the car home. What I'm trying to say is essentially the car is going to be getting worked on now. That's from what I'm getting the impression of. So the company who's working on my car now called me up because they want to order in a new timing belt kit, because here's the kicker: the timing belt is incorrect and it's BS because it's the same. And the reason they want to buy a new kit is because the company who supplied that part and where that part coming from and the reputation of that company for the parts, industry-wise, professionally, professionals don't like that company for their business because they just don't have the quality of parts, and they're just like super, just make the parts super cheap and then we'll just sell them on for lots of money and they'll be incorrect. I'm just looking at this bird that's over there at the bins, distracting me. And my hair is too long, it needs to be cut. Anyway, I'm up for lots more money, still, in my eyes. No one sent me an actual quote. I just got told the timing belt kit is going to be $210. And thus far, the work that's been done is there's been an hour probably installing the pump. There's been half an hour installing the main timing belt already. But that is not the new belt, it's the old belt. So that time is going to more than double to do the timing belts. Because they're going to have to do timing belts yet again. And they might be able to do it quicker than me, I have no idea. So they've spent about 1.5 hours already on it. $140 an hour, that's 70 on 140, you get 210. I'm pretty sure it's 210. No.
Michael, can you shut the gate when you come in?
Yes, because I'm already out here. What's your problem? Jesus. Gosh. Yeah, they've already spent... I can't do the math in my head. My brain can't process it. 140 plus 70, take 60 off of 70, that put it to that, $210. There you go. $210 already in labour, for nothing, essentially. Then we have the work that's expected, which is half an hour to make adjustments to the balance shaft tensioner. Honestly, that's going to be a part of timing, so that's going to be an hour instead, but I'm going to just go over what's here. 1 hour diagnosis of the belt issue on the main, which is the main pulley that has the problem that they have identified. 2 hours to assemble the belt. 2 hours to assemble the belt and timing assembly. 1 hour to install the grill and radiator and hoses, which was generous what I gave them in terms of an hour. Half an hour to check the oil levels, the coolant and fuel, replacing fuel filter or rebuilding or replacing primer as necessary. And then there is set tappet positioning, 1 hour to set tappet positionings to approximately 0.15 millimeters. Then there is 1 hour to install the fuel lines, rails and injectors, check injectors are in good condition to be used with the pump, and then 1 hour to warm up purger from the cooling system and have car running. That's a total of 8 hours of work, according to this. And then there is the parts of $210. And then there is the price, which it says 9.5 hours. In total, there's 9.5 hours I got to pay for, which is $1,330. Add on the parts, you get $1,540. And the price could be higher than this. So this is what my paperwork says, essentially. And this is just from calculating it myself. If you can read this, you get the idea. That's a lot of money. And let me be realistic with you guys, that's literally all the money that I have. I do not have any more money than that. Well, I do, but that money is going to be gone in a couple of weeks' time anyway, so it's not looking good in that sense. We're only on a 12th day. That sounds like my dad's car, but I could be wrong. Imagine my dad just rocks up. Yep, that's my dad's car. He's about to rock up the driveway. Well, no. No. As it got closer, it was like, no, that's not my dad's car. It has a similar noise to it. It's a bit of a higher pitch, I think, my dad's was. As soon as it got closer, it was like, it's actually a lower tone, so it's not the same. So, yeah, I'm not perfect. I don't know my... I don't know what it sounds like. My dad's car sounds similar, but anyway, that's a V8. My dad's a V6. They sound similar. They're not the same. Anyway, moving along. My plan for my car right now is when I get it back, it might go on the road and get driven. It might not. I have to literally get some work that pays money in order to do stuff. Or finish doing my stuff and try to earn... I literally have to earn money now, is what I'm trying to say. So this is tricky. I've also got these stupid little hooks on the end of your nails, like that little piece of thing there to rip it. It's like... That didn't even work. So, whatever. I feel uncomfortable when people look at me like that. Jesus. So, just because of how tight things are getting, just know that there is a chance that Tata is going to go for some money. Because... literally, I might not be able to afford everything that I need to be able to afford, and that's my only way of getting money really easily. There's no guarantees I get anything for it, honestly. It might be only worth scrap value, but then again, it's still better than nothing. That's the end scenario. If I get something for it and I need to get rid of it, look, it's a good project maybe one day, but for now it's like... what are we going to do with it? What are we going to do with it? Because that's going to be an expensive project to work on itself, and then, the Ford Fairlane, they're all expensive projects. And all I was going to do is put another drive line in there and hope that it would improve it. Meaning everything would cost a lot of money, because you'd have to make custom drive shafts, you'd have to make a lot of custom little things, you'd have to fit a bigger engine in that engine bay, it'd need... customized drive shafts and stuff, so on and so forth. At the moment, I have been working on games stuff in my room. That's what I've been doing. And there's mosquitoes flying around, so I got off mosquitoes. I've also been looking after my lavenders for the last couple of days. I had to put that one out in the weather there. They're cobalt blue pots. Yeah, so there's been lots of little things going on. I don't feel like doing anything automotive-wise at the moment yet. I'll only do it if I have to do it, essentially. But it's one of those things where I do need a break from doing the actual stuff. And I do know I've had a long break already from it for 2 months. I need to pull my weight and get something working on my game project stuff thingy. And on top of that, I need to actually get paid work. Like I said, I don't have the money to do anything anymore. It's pretty much, if this doesn't pay off, this doesn't pan out, doesn't get running and fixed and stuff and done right, I'm in trouble. I've already done most of the work right on my engine, so that should be reconditioned to last a very long time, even though I've made mistakes along the way, but hopefully they are only small mistakes and not major mistakes. But the good news is, with any hope, any luck whatsoever, the information that we get from the success in, making this work, will be enough information that we're going to get this white one behind me on the road again. And then this thing will be driving again, hopefully. And when this is driving again, do you know what that means, guys? Do you know what that means if this car here is driving again? Oh, for frick's sake, I hate my camera. When this thing's driving again, it means Dad will have a new car to replace his old car. He's talking about trading them both up to get a new car. That thing's got a rebuilt gearbox in it. That thing will have a new engine still in it, and it's barely done any mileage. But it also, there's another thing about this car. It's only done like 100, 200 kilometers. It's all it's done. So there's another thing. This surface here might need some embrying before we put the thing back together again. I'm also going to check this water pump. Yeah, she'll be alright. There's a feather here from a pigeon that's probably died and gone to heaven. It's, yeah, there's moisture it can get in here, it can make the surface rust. That essentially needs to be looked after until we get the information. Once my car comes back and says, yeah, I'm good, I'm great to go, I'm ready to rock and roll, then the Pajero will go back on the road again. Okay? That's what's going to happen. And then Dad, in all his might and glory, can paint this whatever blooming colour he wants to paint. It'll be his daily project driver thingy, my bobbo. At least he'll have time on his side when it comes to what he wants to do with it. Other than that, he's got the V8, you know, the V8 Ford. We've got the 6-cylinder Fairlane, which is in bits and pieces and not complete at the moment, like fully put together or anything, so there's parts missing here and there. I really need to do something with this car, guys, and I can't do anything while it's sitting there at the moment. While it sits there, it just rusts, it rots away, and then the thing loses value in one way and gains value in another, but it doesn't mean it's benefiting. It was already losing value the moment it got put out in the weather, and it wasn't my fault initially. Initially, it wasn't my fault. However, later down the line, it was my fault because, well, I went looking for a problem, I found a problem, and I didn't get the thing running, I didn't drive it, didn't do nothing with it. It would have been more effective for me to just get this thing running, one. And once this thing is running, then fixing all the other issues with it, and maybe get the rust problems fixed with it one day. At least then I could do whatever I wanted with it. Other than that, I never mentioned this, but my grandparents have finally moved. My grandparents have a nice place. Safer, not in the Adelaide Hills bushfire areas. Lot safer is what I'm trying to get at, so it's ideal. It's an ideal place for them to be. What else can I say about my own place? Well, they've been away from their original home of 40 years. Well, their home of 40 years. They've been away for about 6 months or longer now. And they're still pretty depressed that they've lost their home and they don't have it anymore. But there's a lot less work going into it, so that's a good thing for Mona and Pop. Papa doesn't walk around or do much anymore, apparently, and he was pretty much done. And he reckons he can still drive at 91 years old, pretty much. Or sorry, he's 90. At 90 years old, he thinks he can still drive. My nana says, no, you're going to drive, you don't drive. No, 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 he can't drive. He ran over his foot. And he ran over, he didn't run over his foot, but the car stopped on his foot. And that's when they were like, no more, you're not driving anymore. That's it, you're done, you're finished. They stopped him from driving. It was their safety, you know, concern about safety and stuff. Look, brand new drive belt right there. Little coolie, don't even know what it's for. Probably power steering, but could be something else. Anyway, I'm going to leave the video at that, because I just want to get over this thing, and those freaking birds in the tree are just vandalizing this tree. The Rosellas, lorikeets, whatever, they're freaking good. Hey! Yell at the birds. Anyway, I'm going to go. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being around, guys. And I know these are not as informative or video-like as they are. I feel like these are more like story-based videos now at this point. Even though we've got automotive stuff, it's more like an automotive story series thingy. It's turned into itself. But now we're going to have spare parts because I bought brand new pulleys and stuff to try and save money, and in the end I have to spend more bloody money because wrong parts or something. Anyway, I'm done. Take care, everyone. Bye.